welcome everyone to Celebration Family Worship Center Children's Church. That's a mouthful, isn't it? We're so glad you're here today. I'm glad you brought your Bibles. I got mine, so make sure you have yours. We're going to open up in prayer. We're going to talk about trusting in the Lord with all your heart and growing in Christ today. And we have three young children that want to share a Bible verse with you, so let's pray and we'll just get right to it, okay? Dear Lord, we thank you for this day. We thank you that you loved us, that you came from heaven and laid your life down for us. Thank you, Jesus, for making a way for us to go to heaven. We love you. Lord, we pray that your word will go in our hearts and that we will remember it and be able to grow in you. And we thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, today, you haven't had to see some of the kids lately, but Zach and Olivia and Grayson, they're here today. Well, they're at their own home, and they're going to share a Bible verse with you and how it's helped them to grow. So I'm just going to turn it over now to the Merch Sings. Take it away, guys.
By this we know love, because he laid down his life for us, and we also ought to lay down our life for the brethren. 1 John 3:16.
Then you will call upon me and go and pray to me, and I will listen to you. Jeremiah 29:12.
Blessed are the pure in heart. Thanks be to God.
Matthew 5:8.
Thank you guys for doing that. That was awesome. Grayson talking about blessed are the pure in heart. Yes, when we ask Jesus in our heart and we have his heart, we have a pure heart. And Olivia talking about Jeremiah 29:12, where if we call on God, he will listen to us. And then Zach talking about how Jesus laid his life down so that we all could go to heaven in 1 John 3:16. Just love that, guys. Keep up. Because that word that you shared today is not only helping you grow, but it's helping me grow, and it's helping other children grow. In fact, I wanted to show you a tree I have here. This is like, you'll see a love thing on there. Well, Jesus loved us, so here's Jesus and me. And here's little hearts. It's Valentine's Day coming up. And we just wanted to celebrate with the Word of God. Here is Olivia's scripture right here, Jeremiah 29:12. I don't know if all the other ones are on there, but I'm telling you what, these are great scriptures. See the little birdhouse right there? That's the little eggs. They're going to hatch, and it's going to be new life. Just like when we ask Jesus in our hearts, we have a new life. Here's Sats right here, 1 John 3:16. How Jesus made an opportunity for us to have new life. Is that not awesome? And I know Grayson's is on here somewhere, but I'll find it just a little bit. But every branch, these branches right here, if you wanted to read scriptures about having anxiety or fear or just being scared or something, here's a lot of scripture for that. If you wanted scriptures about Jesus coming into your life and living, here it is. If you want a scripture about how to live for Jesus, like here's Ephesians 4:29. Says, don't let bad things come out of your mouth, but be a good example to other children and adults. And so we're going to get on with our lesson. Let me show you something. Right here is our memory verse today. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Proverbs 3:5. That's only half of it, but I want to show you where it says in the Bible too, and read the whole thing to you. Proverbs 3:5. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and do not lean on your own understanding. Let me read the next one too. I love it. In all your ways acknowledge God, and he will make your pathway straight. Guys, sometimes, maybe this last year, this year, you might have had some hard times. You might have met some people that are having hard times. But guys, listen, you need to trust in the Lord with all your heart. Trust in Him with the good times. Trust in Him with the bad times. You just got to give your life to Jesus and trust Him. Because now we can plan all kinds of things and just make a mess of everything. But I wanted to show you, it's Valentine's Day coming up. When you see this, and I had some more hearts that I wrote out, some more scriptures that I love. And right here is John 15:7. It's kind of shiny, so it doesn't show up. But here's the scripture that God gave us. He's talking about, if you've asked Jesus in your heart and you read His word, if you remain in me and my words remain in you, you ask and it will be given to you. Here's Jesus saying, stay connected to me. It's like if you got a game and it's connected to the wall and it's your power source and it comes unconnected and it don't work because you have no power. It's like Jesus. Yes, remain in Him. He is our power source. And that's in John 15:7. Now here's one that's 1 Peter 2:2. Now this is saying, read your Bible every day. You know, this Bible verse is talking about a baby. When a baby's born, it just wants milk, 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 milk. So it will help them grow in their body. Today, we're talking about reading your Bible. It's going to help you grow in Christ. Just like this tree is growing. Look right down here. It says growing in God's Word. That's how we're going to grow. Right there. So remember, read your Bible every day. Let me come back to this one. Go to God in prayer, okay? Read your Bible every day. Here's another one. John 14:21. Obey God second by second, okay? Jesus says, whoever obeys me loves me, and I love them. And that's where you can find that at, Jesus saying that. So whoever has my commands and obeys, He is the one who loves me. You see, a lot of people might go to church, and they might say they love God, but if you see them out there disobeying, like right here's a scripture that could easily be disobeyed, is talking ugly. This says, don't let any bad things come out of your mouth. These are God's commandments, just a few of them in the Bible. So just make sure that you're obeying Jesus. So we're going to start out praying. You're going to start out reading a verse in the Bible and obeying them. Now here's another one, Matthew 4:19. Now we studied this one a couple weeks ago when we were doing Fishers of Men. It says, follow me and I will make you fishers of men. Well, we want this verse today to mean, show others that you love them. When you ask Jesus in your heart, you're filled with His love. And that love comes out of you. And when you see somebody that's hurt, or crying, or sad, you can go over to them and say, I'm praying for you. I love you. And that is showing the love that Jesus showed when He was here. Now here's another one, 1 Corinthians 3:6. God is the reason you grow. God gives us, if you go to this verse, it talks about how God gives us the increase. You may think now, if you're reading your Bible, and you're studying, you're doing all this, that you're making yourself grow. No, 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 no. It's like that milk being poured into you when you're a baby. That milk is what's making that baby grow. See right here? You got to have roots, and we're going to talk about that. You got good dirt down here, real good dirt. And you got roots going down, and that's going to hold that tree up. And when it rains like it has a couple days, it's just going to make these roots grow deeper and deeper and deeper. God's Word, that's what He's going to do for you. Now, if you go to Proverbs 3:5, this is our memory verse today. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Say that with me, everybody. Trust. Let me hear you. Say it loud. Trust. Very good. In the Lord. Good. With all your heart. Very good. Now let's put it all together. Trust. trust in the Lord with all your heart. You know, there's a lot of people in the Bible, if you were reading it, that's trusted God. I mean, look at the disciples when we were talking about fishers of men, and they caught that big old fish when Jesus told them to throw the net in after they had fished all night. And they knew as fishermen that the fish were out in the deep on the bottom, so there was no way to catch it during the day. But when they caught that all that fish, and it was worth a lot of money, Jesus said, come follow me. He did. They went, they put their trust in Jesus. They left everything behind. Abraham wanted a son for so long, and then God asked him to sacrifice his son to him. And God stopped that angel and said, God sent an angel and said, stop, I know you love me. That's what God wants to know. He wants to know, do you trust in me? All right, let me show you something. So let's think of you, your life. Here you are, here's a string, and you're just dangling down here on your own, okay? But when you ask Jesus in your heart, when you say, Jesus, I'm sorry, and you come grow in him, you're like at the top now because you're walking with God. But if you skip on your prayer, if you skip on reading the word, if you skip on spending time with Jesus and developing that relationship, your roots are going to be very weak. And you're just not going to end up where you wanted to. Now, God loves you. If you say, I'm sorry, he's going to forgive everything, and you're going to be back at the top again. So just remember, don't slip. Don't be like this heart that slipped and just avoided God. You don't just love God when you go to church. You love God every day. I've got a puppet that wants to sing that song to you. I want you to listen. He's got two or three songs. But the first one, again, is our Bible verse, trust in the Lord with all your heart. Okay? So let me go back here. Hey, guys, are y'all ready? Are you ready? You're not? Well, I bet you can get ready, can't you?
Not on your own understanding. In all your midnight. So get ready.
Okay.
Hey guys, in the midst of getting ready, we had a little technical difficulty, so we're going to start all over and do that song again. Somebody must need to hear it twice, because we're talking about getting ready to go to heaven to be with God. All right, hang on, let me see if I can find them. Are you back here? Verses on here. Jesus and me. You're growing in God's Word every time you read the Bible. And you don't have to read the whole Bible at one time. Pick out one verse that you like. Like Zach and Olivia and Grayson did. They picked out one verse. I helped them pick it out. And then they read it. And that word went into their heart. Now I want to ask you, are you ready? Are you ready to go to heaven? Well, if you say, I don't know, let me ask you this. Have you trusted in Jesus? That's a good answer. If you think about it, a verse I love is in Romans. I might not say it word for word, but it's in Romans chapter 5, verse 8, where it's talking about God demonstrated. The word demonstrated means showed. God showed his love to us while we were yet sinners. Christ died for us. Now that is heart. We talk about Valentine's Day coming up. That's heart. That's love. That's real love. So he laid it out there for you. He paid the price. All you have to do is confess with your mouth Jesus and you will be saved. You put your trust in God to take care of your life. So let's just pray together, whether you have one time or if you just messed up today and you want to say, Sherry, I didn't trust God in this today, I'm going to say I'm sorry. Good. That's all it takes. Dear Jesus, we love you. Forgive us of our sin. Thank you for sending Jesus to die on the cross for us. That was such great love, and we love you for that. Help us to read your word. Help us to obey. Help us to share God's word and be a good witness of you so others may get ready and be ready for your return. And we just thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. So remember, pour God's word in your heart. You're going to have strong roots and you're going to grow real big. Now, 1 week coming up, I'm not sure what week it is, but I'm going to show you the tree that doesn't have a lot of roots. But that's for next week or the next week. That however God wants to do it. But guys, it was good seeing you today. Happy Valentine's Day. Remember, when you get those hearts, you think of the heart that Jesus has for you. He laid his life down for you, and he loves you, and he'll help you through anything. You just give it to him. You trust in a God with all your heart. Bye, guys. You have a great week. I love you.